Saints.
You're getting very serious. It's not like you at all.
place. Oh, heard of God's waiting room, but this is like the nurse's yard.
I'm not sure I like your life, this. I'm much more used to the naughty old troublemaker.
Yes, well, it is such good fun. I'm worth a lot of money, me.
Oh, really?
I know how to show a girl a good time. Being rich and all.
All right, Mr. Albert Wealthy Macy, I'll play along. Tell me about it. Where's all this money then?
Well, I don't just have it in my hip pocket. It's invested.
Invested where?
Insurance, that's where. I'm worth over 200 grand.
Insurance money isn't yours, you old fool. It's for those who leave behind once you're dead.
Yeah, well, in that case, I'll just fool them and not die.
There's only one fool around here and I'm looking at him.
You're a real spoilsport, you are. Show us your tits.
That's ridiculous. Is that all you can think about?
Yes, it is. Go on, show me.
No, I won't.
You want to see my todger?
I do not.
Go on, don't be prudish. You want to see my stiffy, don't you?
When was the last time you had a stiffy?
Well, you want to see it anyway?
Of his torment.
What do you mean you're going to kill Albert Macy?
It is my mission from God.
Well, I'm sure that's a very plausible and very laudable motive, but don't you think that if God wanted Albert Macy dead, he'd just give him a heart attack or perhaps have him choke on a fish bone?
Yes. I hadn't quite thought of it like that. A fish bone, you say?
Or a heart attack?
Or a heart attack! Fancy that! A heart attack!
Poison!
I'm sorry?
Poison! That would be better than a heart attack, and quicker too.
Were you listening, Miss Darby?
Yes, dear. But don't worry. Not only is your secret safe with me, I might even beat you to it.
What secret?
What have you got there, my little sex bomb?
What I've got here, Albert Macy, is the germ of an idea.
Germs, eh? Don't let Nurse Mavis hear you saying that. She'll be in quick smart with her mop and bucket, sloshing disinfectant round your ankles.
Let's you and me go find someplace quiet and I'll tell you what I have in mind.
Nothing suspicious, sir. Looks like natural causes. Seem to have a fair turnover in this place.
Nothing suspicious, Constable. What's that then? Is this the dagger I see before me? The handle toward my hand?
Oh, sorry, sir. I must have missed that.
Not to worry, lad. Not to worry. That's why I'm the inspector and you're the constable. I'm paid to notice such things. It looks like a religious artifact.
A religious what, sir?
A religious artifact. Never mind. Just look at all the gold and the jewels. It must have belonged to the church.
Yeah, but rich folks have gold and jewels too, sir.
Yeah, but they keep it hid because they feel guilty about having it. Your church, on the other hand, they flaunt it, parade it about.
And stick it in people's hearts.
I tell you what, Peridon, you go out and look for clues. You know, signs of illegal entry and the like.
M'lady.
I was told you Yes, Mrs. Manning, isn't it? You work here, I understand.
Yep, that's right.
You don't just work here, though, do you? I have it from my records that you own the place.
Well, yes, I do. I don't like to have it known that I do, but you are correct.
And why don't you like to have it known? Is it so that you can listen to all the residents' complaints, do nothing, and then blame it on some anonymous owner?
It's not as simple as that, Inspector. You have no idea what I have to put up with from these people.
These people who pay handsomely for the privilege of living here.
Yes, but the thing is, it's just...
Well, never mind that for the moment. How long had Mr. Mason been living here?
Only a few weeks. He's a very disruptive and disagreeable person.
But not so disagreeable that you didn't mind driving him to the solicitors last week. People talk, Mrs. Manning. People talk.
Look, I don't know what you've been told, but Mr. Mason wanted to finalise his will, and I agreed to run him into town. That's all there was to it.
Do you happen to know if he was married?
He mentioned he'd been married a couple of times.
But not married at the moment?
Not as far as I'm aware.
No regular visitors?
None at all.
And are you aware of the contents of his will? Are you a beneficiary?
Mr. Macy did show me his will, but I promised to keep it a secret.
Mrs. Manning, the contents of the will are going to be made public very soon. So I ask you again, are you a beneficiary?
Mr. Macy left something to everyone in this house. He left me a bedpan. It was his idea of a sick joke.
As the owner of the home, I would have thought the bedpan belonged to you already.
He said he was leaving me the contents. He said that everyone in here smelled of custard and disinfected, so he left us all something equally disgusting. Everyone except her, of course.
Her?
Millie Jackson. She will get his whole life's insurance, over $200,000.
I see. Well, thank you very much for that, Mrs. Manning. That'll be all for now.
Inspector, about me being the owner of...
Just between us for the moment. And I'm expecting a Dr. Turner. Perhaps you would be so kind as to show him straight in.
Dr. Turner? Yeah, I will. Okay, thank you.
Hello, hello, hello. What do we have here? Benzodiazepine. Half a tablet to be taken at bedtime. No name, though.
Ah, you found my sleeping pills, thank you.
And who might you be, madam?
My name is Betty Reed, and those are my sleeping pills. I've been looking for them everywhere. Who are you?
I'm Detective Inspector Sharp, and I'm investigating the demise of poor old Mr. Macy here.
There was nothing poor about him except for his vocabulary. Always effing and blinding he was. A nasty piece of work if there ever was one.
So you didn't like him much then?
Like him. Like him.
Yes, yes, that's enough for now. Do you happen to know when you lost your pills?
Last night. I can't sleep a wink without them. I was told to only take half a one. But sometimes I take seven. And I can sleep for a whole week.
Do you happen to know if there are any left in the box?
Oh, there was quite a lot, but I don't know how many exactly.
It doesn't look like a lot to me, does it, you?
Oh, I don't know, but I can always get some more. My granddaughter works at the hospital. Lovely girl she is. Always makes time to come and see her old friend. Did you know?
Thank you. I don't need to detain you any longer. You be careful with those pills. We don't want them getting into the wrong hands.
Right here, Inspector.
Good evening to you, sir. Inspector Sharp.
Yes, Dr. Turner, is it? I was told I'd be being here with Luke, the coroner.
Yes, yes, he trusts my judgment in such routine cases such as this. Yes, and he's in Sydney today on a conference.
I'll leave you to get on with it.
Inspector, I expect you to speak to us.
I will in due course, sir. In due course.
It was poison, wasn't it?
Poison, madam?
Yes, that killed him. It was poison, wasn't it?
No, ma'am. I don't think so. Not poison. I'll take statements from you both later.
Yes, I'm quite sure that's what killed him.
Inspector, if it helps, the dagger was mine.
I would be inclined to say nothing at the moment, sir, if I was you.
glad that I did it, Inspector. The dagger was mine, but I misplaced
it. I repeat, sir, I would be inclined to forget all about daggers and poisons for the time being. There may come a time when someone will want to ask such questions, but until such time, know what I mean, sir?
Yes, Inspector, yes. Come on, Joan, tie me on the bus of me.
Yes, perfectly straightforward. Natural causes, only heart failure.
Natural causes? What about the dagger?
Oh, no, that didn't kill him. It's probably stuck into the poor chap sometime after he died. Some of the idea of a joke, I suppose.
But it was a joke, wasn't it? So,
there
any need for a
post-mortem? No, there's no need to complicate things. Unnecessarily.
And when you write this up?
The death certificate will say pulmonary edema leading to heart failure. Or something like that. Basically, natural causes. Big vomit.
And the dagger?
There's no need mentioning this, Inspector. Just get some poor old soul in here into trouble.
Right then, Doctor. Under the circumstances, I think I can go along with that. One other thing, though.
Sorry about that.
Have you ever heard of a medicine called benzodiazepine?
Benzodiazepine? Yes, yes. I don't quite prescribe it much myself. Very strong, you know. Very dangerous in the wrong hands. Only administered under close supervision.
Right. Thanks for your time, Doctor.
You're very welcome, Inspector.
So, what have you discovered?
Nothing much, sir.
No, I'm not surprised. Right then, I want you to accompany the deceased to the mortuary and then get about your normal duties. Meet me back here tomorrow morning at 10 and we'll tidy up any loose ends.
Right, sir.
So that we might discuss the demise of poor Miss Macy. Who do you think you are, Miss Marple?
She looks more like Hercule Poirot to me. Since when has he been poor, Mr. Macy?
I don't think it matters who called the meeting. What's important is that we decide as to what, if anything, is to be done.
What do you mean, if anything? We surely cannot let the matter go unresolved.
What is there to resolve? The nasty old man is dead, and there's an end to it.
Yes, a very convenient end if you happen to be the one who killed him with those sleeping pills of yours.
I did no such thing. He was a horrid man, but I didn't kill him. Someone took my pills. This Darby, there was one always going on about poison in him.
He asked me to sit on his face.
Poking around here.
I know why you're so concerned, Nurse Mavis. because of your financial arrangements with Dr. Turner.
I have no idea what you are talking about.
I mean, all those death certificates say natural causes, when we all know that Mr. Baxter died of semolina.
I think you mean salmonella.
More complicated than that. Now, does anyone have anything constructive to contribute to this conversation?
Like why you killed him, you mean?
I didn't know such thing.
You had every reason.
Please listen.
Sure, you'll get to the bottom of it, sir.
I appreciate your faith in me, Ferritin, but I'm not so sure. We have some very sensitive issues in Frau.